Hello everyone. This is an account of my journey to Sierra Leone and my time spent there helping the Waterloo Hospital. Listen to your heart for your God's sake. You'll move a mind. Answer all the prayers that your lips place. Corrupt Bible lies. On Sunday, Julian and I went to a meeting organized by the church elders regarding men in the church. It probably could have been an hour, but it went a lot longer than needed to, and I think it was about 2.5 hours. So far, the only thing I've been cooking for myself is potatoes, but thankfully, Julian and Eric and I all eat lunch together every weekday, so I get a variety. And this is my favorite place to sit, in front of the air conditioner and fan. Here we see Nelly the dog, which got taken back to her original owner later in the week, and a montage that only partially worked of me progressively eating potatoes and a storm coming. The storm took a bit longer than I anticipated. One day Eric came to me looking for specific test tubes for the lab. That sent me to the old store, and as you can see, the new store is a big improvement to the old store. I didn't find very much of the test tubes he was looking for, but at least I found some. So how can it be that you love her? The next clip is of Eric and two locals singing a hymn. First, you'll see them singing it in a local language. I believe it is a Temne. It's not Creole. And the second, you will see them singing it in English. Here we have a full carload because we're going to Freetown to run some errands. But since I have quite a bit of footage of the trip there, I'm going to use this time to tell you all about my troubles in getting the medication for this trip. For those of you who don't know, I have epilepsy, which is seizures, and I take medication for that. And it's a rare medication, and it turns out that the best insurance for me to be on in order to get the medication free each month is state Medicaid insurance. In preparing for this trip though, I found out that Washington State Health Insurance will only give out 1 month of medication for any medication for anyone. After discovering this, my next step was to look into the option of purchasing medication out of pocket. Usually, my medication would go for $3,500 for 1 month's worth, but with a savings card I had, I was able to purchase about 7 days worth of medication for $17.76 at the Walmart pharmacy. I went there every single day and got my week's worth of medication. Let's take a quick break from my story and show you the U.S. Embassy of Sierra Leone. I took a quick video of it, but you can't see it very well, so I took a screenshot of the video, which is why there's a play button in the middle of the picture. Here we see Julian coming back from dropping off Nelly the dog. so we won't have to take care of her anymore. And then we are here entering Freetown. So as you see, it's a lot busier and a lot higher. After several weeks of going to Walmart every single day, I was unfortunately told that I could only use my pharmacy savings card once a month. I was putting their pharmaceutical license at risk by coming there every day and purchasing such a large amount of medication. I even went to Walgreens and a Walmart in a completely different town, but they wouldn't have me. So after trying as hard as I could with this method, I turned back to the insurance company. With the help of a family friend, I filled out an appeals form with the Washington State Health Commissioner's office. But after a while, I found out that they only deal with private insurance companies and not state insurance companies. Somehow, though, my appeal went through and got processed. I sent in all the evidence that would help with my case, such as letters from the hospital and from the doctor, etc., etc., and waited for the reply. And this here is the market of Freetown. It's quite a bit bigger, with two stories, and the ladies are trying very hard to get Eric to buy some clothes. After dropping Nelly the dog off, dropping a doctor off at a meeting, going to a governmental building for some social security issues, and going to the market, we went to lunch and all had egg burgers and slushies. Also, it should be mentioned that Eric did buy like 5 or 6 things. In just a moment, you're going to see the supermarket that the other volunteers and I go to get things that can't be purchased at the local market. To get back to my story though, the appeal that I sent in was denied. And after making a few calls, I found out that for what I was requesting, it was going to be denied no matter what, and I had to fill out yet another form. After filling out another form to overturn the form that I filled out, to overturn the rule that they wrote that I couldn't take my medication, and sending in all the evidence that I was going to Sierra Leone and spending an extended period of time here, I was able to get the full 9 months of medication prescribed to me, and I got it picked up at Walmart and was able to bring it on the plane to Sierra Leone without any problems. Also, for most of you that are watching this in Walla Walla, to give you an idea of how big the supermarket is, it's somewhere in between Grocery Outlet and Andy's Market. In order for the government of Sierra Leone to pay for all the road improvements that have happened just recently, they have constructed toll booths every so often on the roads. And here we have Sabbath lunch. Julian and Eric and I made a feast and enjoyed it very much. Thank you for watching my video, and please tune in next week. But if you close your eyes, does it all